Bonsoir à toutes, bonsoir à tous. Bienvenue à Opinion. Tous les soirs, les
Every
deux
evening,
films en compétition
two
de ce
guests come in to talk about the two films in competition of the day.
Des journalistes des pays concernés. Aujourd'hui,
the journalists come from the countries of the films. We have
David Del Rio Alvarez
from the Mexican press agency. He's going to talk about the Mexican film, the other film, Valley of Love, directed by Guillaume Niclou. Virginie Appiau from Arte, you're going to talk about the French film. In the meantime, let's just talk about the general selection. I'd like to know from both of you what you've liked so far.
Well,
there are several films which I like. My two favorite ones are the Hu Saoxian film and the Jia Zhangke film. For me, there are still some to come. Let's leave them a chance. But my real favorite is Son of Saul. And I really did love Michel Franco's film Chronic. I'm slightly biased on that front. Before we go into depth about Chronic, let's take a look at the atmosphere in the film. Here's the trailer.
See, I like the earlier ones because they're simpler.
It's a Rhine film. You say mine fell Brazilian architect.
Okay. You look him up.
No, let me do.
Okay. Ready, John?
That's art.
Okay, just look
for it. Oh, shit.
Voilà donc Chronique,
so that was a trailer from the film Chronic, directed by Michel Franco, in competition at the 68th Cannes Film Festival. David, what did you think of Chronic? It's a great film. Michel Franco has really done the film justice. I was a bit concerned about some of the films I saw earlier on in the competition, but this film is an excellent one. This is a well-made film. It's his first film in English. He did it on purpose because Tim Roth is English. He wanted Tim Roth to play this particular role. And this is a role which makes the film. It's very interesting, really well made. The only thing is, well, most of the journalists were a bit surprised. We didn't really understand the end of the film. Let's not unveil the end of the film. Of course, it's very unexpected at the end of the film. Of course, it's a violent way of ending the film. There's the music and the credits at the end. It's a bit difficult. It's the end of life.
Qui est un peu le thème du film.
Which is the theme of the film.
Je pense que c'est très bien aussi. C'est le
Another good thing about it is Tim Roth's performance. It's a difficult role to play. He's a male nurse. He's a specialist in his field. He knows all of the professional techniques. He really is convincing as a male nurse, a respite care nurse. So he really did prepare for it. I don't know whether the film will get a prize, but I think perhaps either Tim Roth or Michael Caine could get the Best Actor award. Tim Roth plays the role of a respite care nurse. And during the film, he takes care of three different patients. He goes to their homes and takes care of them until they die. And as you said, he prepared it. Yes, he really is. He identifies himself with this person. He became the nurse. He said it was very difficult. There were difficult scenes in the film, and I had to turn away. It was so difficult to watch. There was a female patient had to be washed.
Michel Franco quand il va danser.
What's he aiming at, Michel Franco? Why does he do that kind of scene? Why does he make us watch the despair of the end of a life?
La fin biais, la mort, même
well, at the
si
end of
ce film-là
life,
ne semblait pas un film très mexicain,
well,
parce que derrière, c'est tourné en anglais, c'est la première qu'il a fait
en anglais, made in English language. He filmed in the States. This is not a very Mexican
film. En tout cas, comme je vous dis, je pense qu'il a été très sensé. C'est lui qui a écrit le scénario. Et je trouve
had a good idea. He wrote the screenplay himself.
Pour raconter cette histoire.
And he is mature enough to recount that story.
Peut-être quelques données assez vite.
Details about him. The screenplay, he wrote it because he had a bad experience in his own private life. His grandmother died, he told us about that. That doesn't happen often on the television. You've got so much experience, I'm surprised you can get caught out. Apologies for letting my phone ring. Oh, yes, so his grandmother was ill, had a nurse come in to look for the grandmother, and when the grandmother died, the nurse continued to visit the remaining relatives. He was quite surprised with that. He was surprised at how attached the nurse had become to the grandmother and to the family, and that was inspiration for the role. He was inspired by the humanity of this nurse who would continue to keep links with the deceased's family. Virginie, we exchanged a couple of words about the theme of death here at the festival this year. Particularly today, the two films today, they both have a central theme of death.
Auquel vous vous attendiez, vous avez été
surprise. Were you surprised to note that theme? There are certain themes that regularly come to competition in Cannes. That's the interesting thing. And death, yes, is one of the themes this year. But it's not saddening, it doesn't make you depressed. Although we see everything, you talked about a body where you see how the body loses its force and strength. You don't say, oh, hell's bells, I don't want that to arrive to me. You see that it happens and you see that it can be managed. So it's a positive thing. And as far as death is concerned, this is a vision which is less Western. It's not death as a tragedy where everything comes to an end, but death for a time for reassessment. Assessment, as if death is not an end. No one has proof of that, of course. But it's very interesting to see that if we reassess our lives in function of these films, to be happier, to be more responsible, to live better, then we will reassess death. And that theme is running through so many films here in the competition without it being too intellectualized or too heavy. It really is lively, paradoxically, and it really is essential. And that is why the competitions here in Cannes, even in the other sections, the parallel sections, not only in competition, all of these films are so very interesting because it applies to films from all countries and they all address the question of death. But death is something which we have to deal with. Death is something which exists and that we should see otherwise. How right you are. The Michel Franco film is not only talking about death, he's also talking about intimacy. We're slightly voyeuristic as we watch the intimate scenes, but the question of death is broached very naturally. There's perhaps another aspect here. Euthanasia and the right of the right to choose the end of your life. This is something which is broached upon. Tim Roth said very simply that he was very involved in the film. He is for the right to die, and he said that nobody, and certainly not the state, should say that someone has to suffer until they die. This is a debate which is also having repercussions in films. In France, there's a political debate among the governments. Yes, indeed, around the world, this is a debate which we need to have. It's not the focus of the film, it's not the main element, but it is, of course, an undercurrent. Because we have a respite care nurse in the film, Chronic, directed by Michel Franco. It's one of the two films in competition. There'll be the red carpet this evening. Earlier on, we had the red carpet for the Guillaume Niclou film, Valley of Love. It was screened at 3 o'clock this afternoon. Let's take a look at a clip and we'll talk about it.
Thank you.
Oh putain, la chaleur.
T'as l'air enfant.
Je suis grossi.
Si tu te sens bien comme ça.
Non, veux-tu que je me sente bien comme ça.
Tu te souviens quand on s'est rencontrés? Tu te rappelles où on était? T'étais beau.
Je suis Michael, c'est moi, ton fils. Je suis l'enfant que tu as mis au monde. Et je suis mort. Je suis mort et toi, tu es vivante. Je me suis donné la mort, c'était prévu. Mais je vais revenir, je te demande d'être présent dans la vallée de la mort le 12 novembre 2014. Tous les deux, oui, tu as bien lu, toi et papa. Tu pourras croire à une mauvaise blague, mais je te jure que c'est la vérité.
Il y a un planning des endroits où vous devez aller, le jour précis et les horaires.
Et 14h04. Il ne viendra plus.
Arrête-toi, arrête-toi. Notre fils te demande de faire cette chose pour lui. Tu es là pour lui. Tu vas faire ce qu'il te demande. Elle vient d'où, cette chemise?
Tu trouves que ça fait beau, c'est ça?
Un peu.
Je t'ai giflé une fois, tu te souviens?
Tu vas confondre.
Je crois pas, non.
Voilà donc Valley of Love, le film de Guillaume
directed by Guillaume Niclou.
J'étais dans la salle tout à l'heure, j'ai vu le film en séance officielle.
At the official screening.
Il y a des moments dans les projections où les silences
moments where there is a silence and it says so much. There's a film, there's a scene in the film where all of the audience was so
extrêmement silent.
It was such a noisy silence. I was surprised by this film by Guillaume Niclou. It took my breath away, it's so powerful. Did you feel the same? The film is amazing because where it starts, a man, a woman who were together such a long time ago, their dead son gives them a rendezvous at a specific spot in 2014 in the Valley of Death and says, I will be there, you will see me. It'll be the last time.
Il faudra you have to come. Pour ce fils qui transmet
and so they do it for the son. The son gives love to the parents, although the son is dead. The love of life, the fact that you have to continue living.
So
there's a notion of spiritualism, but it's very clear, very simple. It's so full of details, this film. Ironical details, there's such a softness, there's such humour, it's very smooth flowing, and the beautiful thing is that this film was not written for Depardieu. It is not a film about Gérard Depardieu, it's not for Gérard Depardieu. It was written for Ryan O'Neill, who has a cancer like the person in the film, who had difficulty with his children, had a broken destiny in terms of his movie theatre. He had a chaotic life, Ryan O'Neill. Depardieu was chosen because the film in English couldn't be made in France, so they had to ask Depardieu, and he embraced the screenplay. Isabelle Huppert is fabulous, although there are times in the film where Gérard does, which is very, very rare, he plays the gobsmacked person. He's not moved, it's more than that, he is just gobsmacked. And there's a physical change, it's intense. And that's what happens on the screen. And there's such emotion, and everybody feels that. And of course, that's a moment I was talking about when there was such a noisy silence in the room. It's a very special film. And Niclou is playing with the music. There's a kind of growling sound. It sounds like the wind. It's very troubling. And he was absolutely gobsmacked. And that's what films are for. And if for that moment, if nothing else, and this film is absolutely amazing. Since the beginning of the festival, we've all been saying, yes, everyone will go and see it, because Huppert and Depardieu are who they are. They played together in Lulu some 35 years ago. But here, we're talking about an actor, Depardieu, but when you're in the film, you forget that it's Depardieu. They're running towards love. It's a backwards race to love. Do you think this is done on purpose? How do you think think the viewers can forget who the actors are. Well, I think three quarters of the actors. Well, there's no problem for them. Because no matter how beautiful the Piala film Lulu was all those years ago, that's not what Niclou is talking about. He has brought to the screen two people of precise age who have lived their lives. By the time you're 60, you've lived your life, more or less. And Niclou shows us that that means nothing. That is nonsense. The son committed suicide. He was not shaped to live, because not everybody has the strength to go on living. But he gives this gift to his parents. He says, your lives are not over. You must continue to live, each one in your own way, in the male way, in the female way, and both of them are going to live that life. Niclou has made a very equitable film. He respects the man, he respects the woman, he judges nobody. And everybody comes to the film with your own sensitivity, your scepticism also. I mean, who's going to believe that someone will come back? Some will believe it, some won't. It's a wonderful film, a great fantasy film. There's some magic in this film. You can't see it, but it's at work. And it leaves traces, it leaves marks on the bodies of the actors. And it's also a film about bodies. Well, it is a fantasy film, a fantastic film. David, what did you think about all of the French films in the competition this year? I think this is the first time there have been so many French films in the competition. Well, I'm not top of the class, I'm afraid, because I have not seen all of the French films. The fact that there are five French films. Well, as we mentioned earlier on, I've done my sums with the press agency, and I was struck by how many films there are. I've been coming here for 15 years, and there are some great films from time to time. But out of the, I think in the whole competition, the official selection, there are 19 French films. How could you say no to Huppert and Depardieu? There's a Mai Wen, which is a very interesting film, Mon Roi. But for the time being, I can say I've heard good critics about the Audia film as well. But that's all for the moment. The rest, I've not really heard too much about them. But Sunday, of course, will, when all of the films are screened again, I'll try and catch up. Just to finish with an anecdote here, I met Guillaume Niclou last January, interviewing him about his two previous films, and he said something very hard to me, very strong. He said, anyway, films that I've made so far, all of the films I've made so far mean nothing. They're shit, excuse me for the choice of word. The only real film I have ever made is the one I've just finished, Valley of Love. And when we see that film, well, I understand his point of view. It really is a change in direction. Virginie? I think, like Chabrol says similar things about his films in the past, but now that we know all of his films, there's always a question of parenthood. All of his past films did lead him here, that's true. But this film is fresh, it's magical. Yes, we agree with you about that. Virginie, David, thank you so much for coming in to give us your opinions. There's a final opinions program tomorrow to talk about the film Chronic with Marion Cotillard, amongst others. So we'll be back tomorrow. See you then.